डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रवीण अग्रवाल फ्रॉम मैनेजमेंट डिपार्टमेंट, रोटरी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. वेलकम्स यू इन टुडेज लेक्चर ऑफ मैनेजरियल इकोनॉमिक्स. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इक्विलिब्रियम और प्राइस आउटपुट डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ परफेक्टली कॉम्पिटिटिव फर्म. इट मीन्स दैट इन परफेक्ट कॉम्पिटिटिव मार्केट हाउ द प्राइज एंड आउटपुट ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर फर्म इज डिटरमाइंड. वी विल डिस्कस how it is done in this topic. In previous lecture, I have discussed about what is perfect market and what are its different features. Today, this is the topic which we are going to discuss. In this topic, when any of the firm in the perfect market is looking for its price or output, then it is looking that particular point of equilibrium when it is earning maximum profit. When we are going to obtain the equilibrium position, the following two conditions must be satisfied. The first condition is marginal revenue must be equal to marginal cost, that is MR is equal to MC. And second condition is marginal revenue curve cuts the marginal cost curve from below. These are the two must conditions in reference of the equilibrium position of the firm. Now, when we are talking about the equilibrium of a perfectly competitive firm, then it is in reference of short run and long run. First of all, we'll discuss how in short run and then how in a long run this equilibrium position is obtained. Come to the equilibrium of perfectly competitive firm. So we have here in short run equilibrium and then long run equilibrium. In short run equilibrium, three possibilities are there. Either the firm will be earning maximum profit when it is when average revenue is more than average cost, or it will be earning incurring losses, AR is less than AC, or earning only normal profit, AR equal to AC. But in long run, there is only one possibility, that all the firms will be earning only normal profits. That is, AR is equal to LAC. That is long run average cost. Now come to the first, that is short run equilibrium. So here we will discuss about the short run equilibrium of perfectly competitive firm. Because as we know, short run is a period where new firms cannot enter the industry, or existing firms cannot alter the size of their plant. So three conditions may arise. Some of the firms will be there who will be earning maximum profits, some of the firms will be incurring losses, and some of the firms will be there earning only normal profits. It means these three conditions arise in short run. Let us discuss these conditions one by one. Come to the first condition. The first condition is maximizing profits. Maximum profits, it means AR is more than AC. It means that maximizing profit situation arises when average revenue of the perfectly competitive firm is more than its average cost. Just look at the graph. I've taken output on the x-axis and price MR, MC and AC on the y-axis. This is the average revenue curve. As in perfect market, we know that price of the product is decided by the demand and supply forces in the industry, and this particular price is fixed. Each and every firm is selling its product at this particular price. It means the price or average revenue curve or marginal revenue curve are parallel to x-axis. Average revenue and marginal revenue both coincide to each other. So this is the average revenue curve or marginal revenue curve of the perfectly competitive market. Okay, now we have to go through cost curves. This is the short run average cost curve. Use it as you are looking here. And this is the short run marginal cost curve, SMC. Now, The equilibrium condition is MR is equal to MC. This is the MR curve. This is the MC curve. Both are intersecting at the point E. This point E is known as the equilibrium point. From this point, we will draw a perpendicular which touch the x-axis at the point Q. It means OQ is the equilibrium output and OP is the price at which the firm is selling its product in the market. Now, look at the diagram. EQ is the average revenue and this EQ is equal to OP, average cost. This is the shorten average cost curve and corresponding to this line C1Q is the average cost and this C1Q is equal to OC. So AC is equal to C1Q is equal to OC. Now we know that profit per unit that is determined by subtracting average cost from average revenue. Average revenue is OP, average cost OC, OP minus OC, this part PC, that is equal to PC. Now total equilibrium output is equal to OQ, this is equal to CC1, OQ is equal to CC1. So total super normal profit will be equal to profit per unit into equilibrium output. Profit per unit is PC and total output is CC1. And PC into CC1, this is the rectangular area PCC1E, because just suppose this is breadth and this is length, so this is rectangular area PCC1E. So this is the super normal profit of the firm represented by the area PCC1E. Okay, now come to the second situation. This is about the minimizing losses. It means that in the industry there will be some firms who will be incurring losses. Loss means average revenue of such firms is less than their average cost. Just look at the diagram. In this diagram, we have output on the x-axis and price AC, MC and MR on the y-axis. This is the average revenue curve. And marginal revenue curve, both are coinciding with each other. Okay, because average revenue is less than average cost, it means average cost curve will be above to the average revenue curve. So I have represented this SAC above the AR curve. Okay, this is the SAC curve, this is the SMC curve. This SMC curve is intersecting the MR curve at the point E. This is the first condition. And MC curve is cutting the MR curve from below. This is the second condition. So this is the equilibrium point E. At this point E, we draw a perpendicular on x-axis. This perpendicular touches the x-axis on at the point Q and average cost curve at the point C1. Okay, so we have average revenue is equal to EQ. This is equal to OP. Average cost is equal to C1Q. This is equal to OC. So loss per unit is equal to average cost minus average revenue. Average cost is OC, average revenue OP, and OC minus OP is equal to PC in the diagram. Also total equilibrium is equal to total equilibrium output is equal to OQ. This is equal to PE. So total minimum loss will be equal to loss per unit multiplied by equilibrium output. Loss per unit PC, equilibrium output PE, PC into PE is equal to rectangular area PCC1E. So this particular shaded area is representing the minimum loss of the firm in the perfect market. This is the second situation. Now come to the third situation of perfectly competitive market. In third situation, we talk about the firms earning only normal profits. Normal profits means average revenue is equal to average cost. It means some of the firms in the perfect market are earning only normal profits. And this normal profit is just sufficient to induce them to continue to operate in the short run. The normal profits are included in the cost. Okay. Just look at the diagram. x axis output, y axis price, cost and revenue. This is average revenue curve of the perfectly competitive firm. MR is coinciding with average revenue. Shorten average cost curve is tangent to the average revenue curve at the point E. This shorten marginal cost curve is intersecting the SAC curve at the point E. Condition of equilibrium, MR is equal to MC, MR curve and MC curve intersecting at the point E, where SAC curve is tangent to AR curve. We draw a perpendicular from the point E to the x-axis, touching at point Q. So OQ is the equilibrium output, and average revenue is equal to EQ is equal to OP, and average cost is equal to also EQ is equal to OP. AR is equal to EQ is equal to OP, AC is equal to EQ is equal to OP. In this way, AR is equal to AC is equal to OP is equal to price. It means this is the condition of normal profits. Okay, now come to the long run equilibrium of competitive firm. Long run situation. As we know that long run refers to a period long enough to change the size of the plant, the number of machines, so as to increase the production capacity in response to a change in demand. Because as we know that in a long run situation, the firm is in a position to alter the size of its plant according to the demand. Also, the firm can increase its demand in the market, increase its supply in the market according to the increase in the demand. Because in long run, it is obvious that there will be an increment in the demand. According to that increase in demand, the firm will increase their supply also. Besides this, looking the supernormal profits possibilities in the market, new firms also enter the industry. It means the firm's supply will increase. Because supply is continuously increasing, so the firms which are earning profits in the short run will be earning normal profit in the long run, because their super normal profit will be absorbed by the more supply in the long run. Also, consider a situation for the firms earning losses in the short run. When we talk about the long run, then they have to go by contracting their output or they will leave the industry. In this way, these firms will be also earning normal profits. It means that in the long run, all the firms in the perfect market will be earning normal profits only. This can be represented graphically as follows. Just look at the diagram. On x-axis output, y-axis price, MR, AC and MC. This is the average revenue curve equal to marginal revenue curve parallel to x-axis. Average revenue curve, marginal revenue curve coinciding with each other. This is the long run average cost curve tangent to the average revenue curve. This is the long run marginal cost curve cutting LAC curve at the point E. It means E is the equilibrium point. From point E, we draw a perpendicular on x-axis, touching it at point Q. So OQ is the equilibrium output and OP is the equilibrium price. It means in the long run, average revenue is equal to EQ. This is equal to OP. Also, average cost is equal to EQ equal to OP. Average revenue EQ is equal to OP. Average cost EQ is equal to OP. It means average revenue is equal to average cost is equal to OP is equal to price. So this is the normal profit condition in the long run. Okay, thank you.